uliofanya kuenda uliongoza msalabani ili tuweze kusimama na Kristo kama Mungu mahali kama hapa, tukikiri, tukisifu na tukiinua jina lako. Thank you. Thank you. hiyo maisha walipotoka katika hiyo njia ya uhai. Lakini tunashukuru siku ya leo kwa sababu Yesu mwenyewe uhai, he himself who is life, he came and he restored us. He restored us ndani yake mwenyewe kila ndani yake unarudi katika hiyo njia.
Thank you. Joshua.
When the Lord was telling Joshua to be strong and courageous. We go to Joshua chapter 1, verse 6. After Moses had died, and Israel was supposed to go and conquer the nations that the Lord had promised, and take the victory that was given unto them. The Lord told Joshua chapter 1, verse 6, be strong and courageous, for you are the one who will lead these people to possess all the land I swore to their ancestors. I will give them. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the instructions Moses gave you. Do not deviate from them, turning either to the right or to the left. Then you will be successful in everything you do. You see, in this life of Christ, he uhai uniko ndani ya Yesu. Uhai ni tuko nayo siku ya leo. Kwa sababu yeye peke yake anaweza kupenda uhai, kwa sababu yeye ndiye uhai. We are alive because of the mind. The life that you have right now, that I have right now,
the truth.
need to proceed. That is the attitude that the Lord wants to put in our hearts. Because our hearts have very many needs. I feel like the heart has very many sides and chambers. Things that are hidden, that only He who reveals that which is hidden can be able to fix, can be able to readjust some certain attitude. They came and gave a good report. Why? Because there was an attitude in their heart, an attitude of courage in their heart, an attitude of courage in their heart, an attitude of courage in their heart. So, what is our attitude? Because we have been called unto the nations, just like Israel was called to go and conquer the nations, to go and conquer the lands, to go and conquer and possess. We have been told to go in. And as we are going, how is our heart? What attitude do we carry in our hearts? Because the Lord is with us. That means we have strength. We are strengthened. He is our strength. He is our strength. But what is the attitude of our hearts as we are going to conquer? Because if we go like the other, like spies who went, and come back with a bad report, with the wrong attitude, you know what happened to them. They were cut off. They were cut off. They were unable to actually go and possess. So it is important that even as we go into the nations, we need to go with the right kind of attitude, the right kind of outlook. And that attitude and outlook is an outlook and an attitude of courage. It's an attitude of courage. It's an attitude of courage that the Lord wants to readjust, wants to solidify. And we need to allow the Lord to expose those things that will hinder this courage in us. It was not an accident that it was Joshua who was told that he was going to lead them. It wasn't an accident. He had it in him. The Lord just had to bring it out. So when he was telling him to be strong and courageous, the Lord was calling that courage out. It was already there. It was came and gave a good report, the right report, the report of faith. That means the courage was already in there. The courage was already in there. Some of us, we may have courage, but we may not know. Some of us, we may not have courage, but we need courage. So the Lord needs to readjust. The Lord needs to readjust the attitude of our hearts and fix courage so that as we go into the nations to conquer, and there was victory after victory. So if we have to have victory after victory, we need the right attitude. Our heart needs to have the right attitude. The attitude of courage needs to be conceived in us. It needs to be released. Let the Lord call out. Be strong and courageous. Esther, be strong and courageous. Let Him call it out. And if it is not there, let Him fix it. Let Him fix it. Let Him readjust. Let him readjust that attitude so that we are able to possess, this inheritance that is given unto us. Otherwise, we lose. You can have something in your hands and it slips through your fingers just like that. We have seen, we have learned. These things are written so that we are aware, we learn. And we don't want to fail like the other spies here. We want to go in and possess like Joshua did. We want to go in and possess. We are at that point of going in to possess. So we need that attitude of courage in us. And this morning we are asking the Lord, Lord, have mercy on us. We do not want to fail. We do not want to go with the wrong attitudes into the nations. We do not want to walk with the wrong attitudes into the nations. We do not want to go with the false attitudes that are not of faith. We want to go in courage. Courage, because we know that you are nation. Speak to the Lord. Let him readjust the attitude. Let him call out the attitude. The way he called out to Joshua. Yeah? He's strong and courageous. He called it out. You see, when he speaks, it becomes. When he speaks, it becomes. I know it's how it most of the time is negative. He was commanding. He was commanding something that was there. He was commanding. Let the Lord command it out. Let him command it out. Be strong and courageous. And he was. Joshua became strong and courageous. Be strong and courageous. An attitude of courage. Our hearts. Our hearts. Our hearts. Our hearts. The attitude of our hearts. The attitude of our hearts. Because strength alone is not enough. Strength alone is not enough. Strength alone is not enough. Our hearts need the right attitude. Our hearts need the right attitude to possess. We want to possess. Because victory is starting. Victory is starting. Victory is starting. We have seen him do it before, and he will do it again. 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 But we must have the right attitude. An attitude of courage. An attitude of courage. An attitude of courage. Let him call it out. Let him readjust the right wires. The right wires. Let him fix. Let him fix it. Let him fix it. Let him fix it. So that we are found faithful. So that we are found faithful and we are able to hold this victory. We are able to capture these nations for Christ. For the glory of his name. We are able to possess these nations for Christ. For the glory of his name. The glory of his name. To the glory of his name. We don't know what we are going to face. We don't know what we are going to face. He knows. So let him call it out. Let him readjust. Let him amplify if he's amplifying. Let him put that courage in. Let him adjust that attitude. That attitude. Anything that is wrong, let him take it out. Tell him not take it out. Take out everything that is going to fail. Everything that is going to fail. Everything that is going to fail. Because there is no failure. There is no failure. There is no failure. Victory is certain. There is no failure here. There is no failure here. He has never failed. He has never failed. He is a faithful God. He is a faithful God. And he is with us. He is with us. He is Emmanuel, God with us. He is Emmanuel, God with us. We need that courage, that boldness, that boldness that the godly are called to have. That boldness that the godly are called to have. Lord, give us that bold attitude. Give us that bold attitude. Where we have been timid, Lord, we refuse all this timidity. We are no longer walking in timidity anymore. We have refused. We are not going to the nations as timid people. We are going boldly with an attitude of courage to conquer. Because we know that the Lord is with us. We know that he has given this possession unto us. In the name of Jesus Christ, we know that he has given this possession unto us. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that even as we are readjusting this attitude in our hearts, Lord, that we are fixing the right attitude. As we are fixing the right attitude in us, Lord, Lord, even as we yield our hearts to you, we ask that you continue to give us strength. Because strength and courage walk hand in hand. Continue to strengthen us, Lord, even as courage comes. Continue to strengthen us even more as courage comes. Continue to strengthen us even more as courage comes. Continue to strengthen us even more. Ask for more strength. Ask for more strength. Ask for more strength. Ask for more strength. He will give. He will give. He will give more strength. He will give more strength. He will give more strength. Strengthen my feet, Lord. Strengthen my feet. Ask him to strengthen me. Strengthen my hands. Strengthen my feet. Strengthen my hands, Lord. He also strengthens our hearts. He also strengthens our hearts. Like courage is the strength that comes. just about putting your hands and your feet here. No. Strength begins in the heart. Strength begins in the heart. And as He strengthens our hearts,
the right way. Moses did not know that Moses was taking care of you. He went to
down. All the time, not God. God is never defeated. It is the attitude of our hearts. And that comes in between and very many other things, but when you talk about courage, it is courage that he wants to give us. It is courage that he wants us to have. That courage to face level. I don't know how many of us will be able to face level at this point. Or perhaps go.
Let us be before Him.
Let us pray before you, let's rebuild. Let's rebuild. That you may be able to follow instructions. So obedience is key. Obedience, as much as the strength in the heart, there's obedience. Obedience is key. Obedience is key. And lastly,
yeah.
that may have that we not repeat the same mistakes. We cannot repeat the same mistakes when we have seen and we have done. Amen. Lord help us. Lord help us. We need to watch. We need to be alert that this is the man of God. I am aware, I'm watching, I am sober. I'm not just ravishing and I'm not murmuring in the background. Because those who ravish the murmur perished. They did not inherit even though it was there. I want to say my why.
Thank you.
people know